Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum, dear students. So in our previous lecture, we discussed that what is a computer and where the computer is used and how the computer works. So now again, let's revise how the working of the computer. So student, as we know that the computer doesn't know, cannot understand our human language. It converts our language into a binary codes. Binary codes means zero and one's language. This is called the computer language, and a computer follows the three steps to perform any task. First step is input. Input means that we are giving instruction through any input devices. We have some input devices, so with the help of these devices, when we are giving instructions to a computer, so this is called input. And instruction is in the form of the data. In the form of the data, and data means that the raw facts or figure. Data is raw facts or figures, so the instruction is in the form of the data. The second one is process. Process means that when with the instruction that we give to the computer solve the problems. A computer works on these instructions, means it means to calculating or sorting the data using CPU. So using CPU, the computer process the data. And output means when the computer processes on this data, then the computer gives us the result of that data. It means giving the result of processed data through the monitor. Through any monitor, means through any output devices, when the computer gives us the instructions, yani that's the instruction is in the form of the information. So information is a processed data. So computer works in these three following steps. So now there are some examples related to input, process and output. Now let's discuss one by one. There are some ingredients. When here a picture show the how sandwich ingredients are processed, and finally you get a sandwich. It involves the three steps. First you provide ingredients for a sandwich. For making sandwich, first you provide the ingredients, like we have a bread, we have some fruits here, we have yogurt here. So these ingredients are called the input. Cucumber is there, tomato is there, cheese is there, cream, etc. So these are called the input. While making a sandwich, we need ingredients. So these ingredients are called the input. Means we are giving some instruction. These are called ingredients, and the ingredients are chopped up and mixed well to be inserted between the bread slices. So this is called that we are doing the process cycle. After that, we get the sandwich as a result. So the result is called the output. We have some another example, like we have ATM card. So the ATM card is the input. Is input when we enter the ATM card to ATM machine. So this is called, so there the process step is done here. And after that, when we enter our ATM card into a ATM machine, so we get our notes, our money. So this is called our result. So this is called the output. And when while making our orange juice, so the oranges we have input, and when we grind this oranges in a juicer, so the juicer here, the process step is done here. After that, we get the juice. So the juice is called the result. So these are the some examples related to input, process and output steps. Similarly, a computer is also a machine that carries out same functions. It also follows these three steps. So computer follows these three steps. For example, if you want, so students, for example, if you want to add three numbers on the computer, then it works as follows. Like when you want to add three numbers, so first of all, students, you give instructions through our input devices. Like for example, like you type 2, 3, 2, 5, 3 through the keyboard, and keyboard is input devices, mean we are giving instructions to the computers and give the correct instructions add, and we give here add sign that add these three numbers. Thus this is called the input. After giving the instructions, the computer process on the process these instructions means the computer add these numbers according to our instruction, and this is called the processing. And output, the third step is output. So the result of adding 2, 5 and 3 is 10. So thus it is the outcomes of the processing that appears to your monitor. So this is called the input. First we are entering here, we are giving instructions to our computers, and the computer process on these instructions and gives us output. So these three computer works on these three steps. So I hope so that you are getting my methods. I hope so that you are getting